Welcome to Tone Talks. Welcome to Tone Talks.
How's everybody doing today? This is Antonio Moore coming to you from Tone Talks. I just wanted to do a brief video just to talk about Thanksgiving and how I feel everybody should approach it as we come into these days of giving back and giving thanks for the year that we might have had. So essentially this Friday, I want to just tell you, this Friday, Tone Talks won't be on the air celebrating Thanksgiving. I'll be back on the 30th. Just wanted to start off by saying that on Dash Radio, 7 p.m. this Friday, we won't be on. It will be a rerun. But I wanted to kind of talk about Thanksgiving a bit, give my take on it. Everybody has different takes on it, and I'm not at all trying to pressure anybody to celebrate a holiday that they might not feel supportive of. You know, I understand the whole backdrop of Columbus and the Indians and whether you want to celebrate Thanksgiving. But for black folks, you know, Thanksgiving has taken on a message of like family, connection, giving thanks and getting together and having food and celebrating. But I think as we go into that week, we need to start looking at this thing in a broader context and bring ourselves together for a bigger meaning. You know, me, myself, sometimes on social media, what I try to share is different chances that I have to give back to homeless black men and black women around Los Angeles. You know, Skid Row has the highest concentration of homeless in the nation. I commend those people who go down there and feed people. I see it all the time on my Facebook. Shout out to y'all. But as I see black homeless men and women, I try to give them water. I try to give them support. You know, and also I try to share it on Facebook, not in any way to show them out, but to more so give everybody a different meaning on social media. Because I think in so many ways we celebrate vacations, we celebrate celebrity, we celebrate birthdays, but we need to use this to celebrate giving. And I feel like when we do that, what we'll have is we'll have a chance to share that giving and maybe spread that message to somebody else who gives back as well. This is an important time, important moment. You know, we've talked about it on my channel about government cutting back. And I don't think it's necessarily right that we have to give for them to be able to eat, but that's the necessary of the moment. You know, in some instances, what you're seeing is they're cutting back on services for people to get turkeys and Thanksgiving at these shelters. And I'm not at all telling you to walk around and find people to give turkey to. But I just say, like, when you see another man, when you see another black man and black woman particularly, you definitely should take a step back and wonder whether you have enough to give. I was coming out of a Ralph's just to share a moment for me, and I had bought 8 pieces of chicken. What am I going to do with 8 pieces of chicken? So I gave the lady 2 of them, and the homeless lady, and she felt more than happy for another more recent time. I'm at the car wash, and I saw a black man that was drying cars with flip-flops because he didn't have shoes on. The Lord has blessed me with abundant shoes. Even though I wanted the shoes that I had, I still gave them to him because he probably could put them to better use. Definitely be using those instead of flip-flops. I'm not telling you to give your stuff away, but I am telling you that it's time for us to make judgment about what we have and what we don't have to give. Now, in terms of family, there's a larger discussion going on. I've seen it on Breaking Brown, and we've talked about that on my channel, about what are the boundary lines to give in terms of family repetitively, you know, in terms of sisters, in terms of mothers, and that's a discussion to have on another day. For this week, what I just say is let's just get into the mode of looking around at what we have that we don't need, that somebody might need more of. From shirts, to jackets, to shoes, to toys, to clothes, to hugs, to love, to everything. Because so often what we get caught up in is in ourselves, in our daily lives, and we just celebrate Thanksgiving in terms of eating, but we don't celebrate it in terms of giving thanks. So we understand that the material wealth condition of black folks across this nation isn't great. Middle black family, $1,700 without depreciating assets. So I know a lot of you guys don't have a lot to give. But what we got to understand at the same time is that we all have family that's in the streets, that's coming out of jail, that's living this hard life of being black in America. And don't just give because you might be that person next, in the sense of, I hope somebody looks out for me. Give from a place that makes you really connect with why you give and why you connect with the next man. And I feel like some of us, what we're having as a problem is we're being asked to give all the time. And I can't tell you what to do in that context. I'm just saying that right now, at this very moment, make sure that you cut to the heart of what Thanksgiving means. Because to me, it means giving thanks. Giving thanks to get through a whole nother year, hopefully healthy. To have children that are healthy. To be able to go out and enjoy them playing their sports or whatever they're doing. To be able to go to work with a tank of gas. To be able to put food in your refrigerator. And I just hope that you can pass that along to the next man. And I really think at the same time, it is important to push government. And push government to do what it's supposed to do as far as servicing people, particularly American DOS, American Descendants of Slavery, because we invested so heavily in the country and the country owes us such a debt. For a lot of us, that's hard for us to understand because we built our context and our lives around self-responsibility. But at some level, you have to hold the government responsible as well for what it owes for us paying taxes, for us investing as slaves into the country, for us being here and being part of this country at all, for us protecting and, you know, my brother is in the armed services. And for to go out and protect this country, protect us from everything that's happening abroad, you know, it owes us for that as well. And I'm just saying to you, happy Thanksgiving, and may you be safe as you travel around the country to see your own family and celebrate these holiday seasons. And I didn't want to, you know, I don't want to hold you guys too long. This is a short video. I think Thanksgiving, as we turn the corner, turns into Christmas so fast. And Christmas is about presents. But celebrate this with your family, with your young ones, with your parents, and celebrate it in a way of where you understand that you have an obligation that goes well beyond you to give back at this time. Again, Tone Talks this Friday will not be on the air, 7 p.m. in Dash Radio. We will return next Friday, the 30th, and look for it with a hot topic. We're going to have that discussion. Thank you.